Hello and welcome, beautiful people, in another video. And this video is something which I have thought a lot of time on, and on which something I got a lot of question on, and I decided, okay, let's work over this video. So as an Indian, one of our biggest problem is building a business from India and growing it globally. This is one of the biggest challenges as per to me that I think that we people face in this time. Ki, what should we do that can take and go beyond our boundaries? So we'll try to answer that in this video. The topic of this video is how Indians can create a global agency. So you can say how Indians can build a business without a big investment. And this is not just about Indians. It's how anyone can build a business by leveraging a particular process in particular way. In detail, we're gonna be going in detail about this topic and how they can use this thing to grow something globally for the global market, for the international market. So that's what we're gonna be doing in this video. This, before starting this video, please do like this video, subscribe this video. I know you won't share it, so there's no reason I'm asking for that. I never share it, so why you would share it? So there's no reason of point, but liking and subscribing is very easy, guys. Just do it, yeah. Just do it. I'm spending my another 1 hour for recording this video. So just do it. Let's get started without further delay. And if you're watching me on Facebook or Instagram or my group, tag your people. Let me know what is the problem that you are facing. And I'm always ready to help you out as a friend, as a mentor, as a bro, the way you want. Thank you. Let's get started. So we would be talking about how to grow an agency from India or from any part of the world and just grow it globally. So basically, before talking about all these fancy things like agency and things like that, what is actually an agency? What do an agency stands for? So let's say in a very, 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 very open manner, an agency is simple. A business where you help client or you help businesses to achieve an objective in their business, something like creating a website or helping them to do the hiring or some other process. You help these people to get those processes done and you are an expert in that. The only reason clients hire an expert agency or clients hire an expert agency because they know that agencies are good enough to do a particular job because that's what they do, okay? Agencies are specialists to do things, okay? So that's all the layman definition of an agency. Another way of understanding an agency is agencies are a group of people who have a designated job role to complete a big work very easily. Okay, for example, if there's a marketing campaign, all the people work in a synchronized way to get that process completed. Now, who are the clients for us? Anyone who needs to get a job done that we are offering as a service is our client. Okay, that's a layman definition of an agency. Now, there are a lot of questions that you would think that you can have it in your mind. So we'll go with one question at a time and see. There are pillars of an agency and I have tried to break down those pillars. Or basically, I have tried to break down what you need to just grow an agency from India for the global market. You need investment. Investment is the key. And you'll get to know how much investment you need. Then comes the mindset. Mindset plays a really important role when you're trying to go something out of the country, out of your comfort zone, and you're trying to take it globally. Next is partners. Very important. Nothing can be as important as a partner. Next is contracts, because it's not just I'm a person who likes to trust people. You can easily gain my trust, but though I am like trusting people easily, I still follow the contracts because I see that these are a great way. It can be as simple as an email based contract where I say something, someone replies something and it becomes a contract. So it can be as simple as that. Then checking out the legal aspect. Then the next option is hiring, and scripts plays an important role. Now, what script? I'll tell you about that as well, but just we'll leave it for now. Okay, we'll leave it for now. So next thing is, the first thing first is investment. How much investment you need to create an agency? And by the way, let's talk about one more important aspect. What are the type of agencies? Because agency is not just marketing agencies. There are a heck lot of agencies. I'll tell you example. There are recruitment agencies which recruit people for multinational companies, for big companies, okay? Because big companies don't want to put their time in hiring people for low level positions. They want to put their time in hiring the great talent at higher level. So there are recruitment agencies, there are marketing agencies, there are email writing agencies, there is e-commerce specialized agencies, there's Amazon focused agencies, there is like for any business that you talk about, there's an agency for it, or for any service you need on internet or in the general world, there's an agency for it. There's an agency, there would be type of agencies that would be help you to manage an event. There would be agencies that help you to find a bride or a groom, like aapki shaadi karane wali agencies. So remember Popatlal? He is always going behind those agencies, marriage bureaus they call it. Agencies are like that. But particularly right now, while we are doing this video, we'll be focusing on one thing: what is a marketing agency and how to grow a marketing agency? Because my agency or my talent is only in growing marketing agencies, or basically in helping people to give out their marketing related services or their development related services, or services that can be offered via internet. Okay, that comes via internet. I have specialization in that. So basically website development, all the things that we would talk today certainly relates to website development agencies, graphic designing agencies, creative agencies, I would say branding agencies, social media marketing agencies, and this sort of software development agencies. So this video is in general for them, okay? So what's the total investment required? So the total investment for the start is ₹0. You don't need to invest any money because it's getting client. You don't have to buy any product to start an agency. You don't have to start adding team members on the day one itself. You don't have to buy something get started. You should know the basics of an agency. This video would cover, and if you need more knowledge, there's a link here. Get access to the best way of growing your agency with a complete course here. devrasingh.com/ags-2. Okay, just check out this page. You'll get a great offer, great product, okay? And a lot of reviews, obviously. We give out a lot of reviews. So you can check that out stuff here. You just need zero investment. The one thing that you need to start an agency is the commitment. And see, focus is also one thing that is required in an agency, because agency is not profitable business. Like it's a business with highest profitability, but it's not a business that you can start with day one, because you need to connect with people. You need to network with people. You need to prospect for the people. Networking means meeting 2-3 different business owners in a day. Prospecting means reaching out to more business owners who can give you the job. And then comes, so this takes time. And I would say the best you can get it in 3 months. Okay. Next is teams. Teams play a really important role. That's the only investment I would say when you're growing, you require, because a agency runs on people. You can have a completely remote agency like me, where I work from India. My team members are working from Philippines, Pakistan. There's guys from different parts of India. And there's one person who's working right now from Malaysia. So we have people, and there are salespeople who work from US. So we don't have to pay any cost for their living. We just have to pay them salaries. And that's the major chunk of our cost. Like teams. Play the salary of our teams is a major investment, and basically we make 3 times than what we pay. So agar hum kisi bande ko 10,000 pay kare, to we make 30,000. So if we are paying somewhere around 10,000 to a person, we are making 30,000 from it. 30,000 in terms of rupees, and if anyone wants to in terms of dollars, so we are paying $3,000 and we are making around $6,000 back. Okay, so that's how the calculation is. Next is paperwork. So you may need some money for doing the paperwork. For example, paperwork they include, like if you have a CA, if you are working with a CA or chartered accountant, or you are working with a financial person to manage your taxes, auditing and other stuff. So you need to put in your money on paperwork, and it includes the legal aspect as well. So if you need any files to be done, software, like contracts to be prepared, things like that. So this is all called paperwork part, and paperwork can be handled by an external team or an internal team, but it requires some cost. So it just plays like it would take around 3-5% of your money. And just to tell you what's the profit margin in agency business, while typically in e-commerce, the profit margin is around 13-25%. That's the typical profit margin around e-commerce. The typical profit margin in an agency is way above 60%, okay, or way above 40%. So it's between 40-60%, depending upon the way you operate and the way you. So the more you hire, your profit margin shrinks, but hiring more people gives you that comfort, like gives you that comfort to work in the way you want. So that's the only cost. Next is the softwares and tool cost. While running an agency, if you want to automate a majority of day-to-day jobs, you would need the softwares. You would need a lot of softwares and tools, and these cost like out of the money that you make, 10-12% or 10-15% of your amount goes into your softwares and tools. The majority big chunk after teams, I would say, that goes in an agency is actually learning, which means learning and mentorship. Okay. It just takes a significant amount of revenue, because mentorship and learning is something that should never stop, because you cannot be the best at all given moment of time. So that's why I think that learning and mentorship plays a really important role. And right at the present moment of time, I am investing money in learning more things, in growing the things in a better way, creating more processes, creating more specified processes. So I think that this is a great return on investment. And by the way, it's all return on investment. I always talk about, you'll always, on my channel, you'll always hear me talking about ROI. ROI stands for return on investment. How much I'm investing and how much I'm getting back. That's called ROI. Next is mindset. Okay. And sorry, I missed the tool called as payment gateways. So out of, let's say, $100,000 you receive via your payment gateway, you don't make that $1,000 in your bank account, in your Indian bank account. There goes some money in terms of conversions and in terms of fees. For example, I'll give you a rough example. Today, I got $1,000. I'm just giving you example of today itself. I got $1,000 in my PayPal. Okay, so the two softwares that we use for payment is Stripe and PayPal. So these are the two softwares that we use, and sometimes Payoneer. Okay, so these are the three tools that we use. So payment gateways, let's talk about payment gateways. So if a client pays me $1,000, okay, so typically, according to the Indian calculation, we should make in our bank account 72,000 rupees. I don't know what's the dollar rate right now, but the current rate at the day I'm recording this video is 72 rupees. So I should, from the rough calculation, I should make around $72,000, but that's not the case that you make 72,000. Sometime it happens. First of all, out of the $1,000 that you receive, some money goes as a payment gateway fees, and it's called as payment charge. For example, out of $1,000, you'll need to pay somewhere around 5% plus taxes, which is around, I'll give you the rough number. Out of $1,000, I get in my bank $946. So you can calculate $54 is being deducted from my bank account, or like from the money that I make. Next, let's move to then another part. And what is then the calculation all around payment gateway? So that money gets deducted, and there is some money that's being charged on converting that amount and sending it into our bank account. So out of the $946, I get somewhere in my bank account 63,000 or 65,000 rupees, depending upon. So the person has sent 72,000 rupees, and I get 63,000 to 65,000 in my bank account, which is completely not a bad number. which is completely not a bad number at all. Next is mindset. Mindset plays a really important role when you are trying to grow an agency, because you are doing something which is way beyond a normal person's capability, or which is way beyond what normal person is thinking. You are trying to grow something from a country to another country, to complete new geographic, to complete new places. So mindset is the key. Okay. You don't have to stop learning and you don't have to stop growing in an agency. So growth is the key. Growth in terms of your personal knowledge, growth in terms of your agency, growth in terms of hiring, growth in terms of working with new talents, growth in terms of creating new processes, growth in terms of buying new softwares and using them for automation. So growth is the key. Now, growth can have a lot of different parameters. Okay. Growth is not dependent on one parameter at a time. Growth is dependent on a lot of parameters. So I cannot say that this is something that I can term it as growth. Your increase in your money or your increase in the money coming into your bank account is not a growth at all. Okay. It's a byproduct of a lot of factors that you do. So growth is the key, but there are a lot of factors that influence growth. Next is think of ACV. ACV is called average customer value. Okay. There are different name of like people call it as different way. So in a typical agency, like at the point we are charging around $2,400 to around $3,500 and above in order to get, like in order to work with a client, and there's some commission attached to what sales we provide. For example, if we are working at a price point of, let's say, $2,400, then out of those $2,400, we charge a commission fee over our service. For example, it can be like 15 to 20% of the ad budget. That's what we do. So think of ACV. ACV is the key. And mindset, what the point here in the mindset is, when you grow global, you make more money. Because now, if our Indian market is of 50, when I was working in an Indian market, it was hard to get a client for 20, 30,000 rupees. Okay. And now we don't talk to a client if he's talking about working for less than $1,500. We don't even talk to them like in a good way. So, or it's not like we are rude to them. It's like we say that you are not a choice or you are not the type of customers we are looking forward to work with. That's how simple we are. Because we know that if we are working with that client at $1,500, we would be not able to pay the salaries of the people that would be dedicatedly working on this project. Because again, we are growing global, okay, or as we are building out the teams for a growth of the company, we need to pay high. You need to pay high to get new talents, to get fresh talents, to get good talent, okay? So that's the reason we kept the AOV, ACV, which is average customer value, very high. It's typically around $1,500 to $2,500. That's the bracket one. And the bracket two is around $3,500 plus commissions. We take commissions on the number of sales that we do or on the ad budget that we spend. Next is, in order for the growth of the company, your ethnicity and the race doesn't matter. Ethnicity, I'm an Indian. Why would people trust me? I don't have an American accent. You can see that I don't have an American accent. I talk in the way other Indians talk. Okay. I don't have an American accent. And you don't even need to have an American accent, because as per my experience in that market for the last 3 years, what I can say in a very well-framed manner is a customer does not look for someone who's fancy. He looks for someone who is as simple as he wants. Majority of my customers or majority of the clients that I've worked with, they don't care about what accent you have or what ethnicity you have. Okay, so basically I work in the field of softwares and e-commerce, and their ethnicity and these things don't matter. So the only thing that people care about and that people have a look over is how trustworthy you are, how simplistic you are. And when you try to see, you'll see a lot of people on Indian YouTube or Indian YouTubers, Indian coaches as well. They are trying to change their accent For example, hey, welcome to this video and the ethnicity and girl and growth is the key, and they talk like this. That's not their accent. Okay. They are just trying to create an accent which they have learned sometimes, and sometimes what maybe it could be a Rafael joke or a LOL joke, but they are trying to create an accent which is not their real accent. Okay. And I don't like people who just try to manipulate themselves, and clients. Okay. Clients as well don't like a manipulated person. They like to see you the way you are. So be yourself. Okay. It's not that for a client you have to change your ethnicity. Okay. Be proud of your ethnicity. Be proud to be Indian. Be proud to have this tone. Be proud to have this accent, or be proud to represent your culture. Okay. So see, sometimes when we have a holiday, like on Diwali, we have a holiday, and for the 5 days of Ganpati, we have a holiday. Though all our clients are international, we tell them that as we are Indians and we have a break for this moment of time, this is one of our festival when we focus and we devote ourselves to God. So we'll be not working for the next 5 days. So we respect our culture and we try to tell our culture to the people, and that creates a really good vibe between you and the client when you tell these points. Next is have a goal for your agency. And when you have a goal from your agency, your processes will handle. Now, what's a process? Process is simple. You want to convert a client from prospecting to sales. You need a process for it. First step is this. Second step is this. Third step is this. So this is called processes. Processes play an important role in growing up your agency. There's nothing as important as creating processes, what we call as standard operating procedures, SOP. SOPs play a really important role in the growth of your business. Your agency should work even when you don't work. That should be the goal of your agency. Even if you don't work, your agency should be at a point when things work without your help, or things work when you don't touch your computer or when you don't touch your laptop. That should be the way you should build an agency. Because if you're trying to build an agency, which means you want to free yourself from a job, you don't want to get into that job matters and other things. And when you want to do that, okay, when you are looking to do that, you can't be a slave of your own business. That's a wrong thing. You can't be a slave of your own business. So the whole point here is create processes so that new team members can learn how you guys work, or new team members can learn how things happen. Next point is partners. You are growing in a country, or you are trying to grow a business where you don't know anyone, where you don't have a lot of people. So for that reason, you need to have partners. You can have white label agencies, power partners, and niche specialists. I'll tell you what are the three. First thing first is white label agencies. So as you are an agency in India, there would be a lot of agencies in US, there would be a lot of agencies in UK, there would be a lot of agencies in Europe, there would be a lot of agencies in Australia. So what you can do is you can partner up with these agencies in the foreign countries. And so let's say they do a contract with a client in Australia. Let's say we are three agents. There are two agencies, Agency A and Agency B. Agency A is based out of Australia, and Agency B is your agency based out of India, or based out of Pakistan, or based out of Bangladesh, any country of your choice. Okay. Or based out of any countries in Europe, but you are looking to grow your brand into that market. So, or you are a really small agency in US and you want to grow in Australian market with our agency up there. So what you can do is agencies A, okay, the agency A can partner up with agency B. Agency A has a contract with a client to get a work done, let's say of website designing. So agency A is based out of Australia. They do a contract with a client and they charge him, let's say, $2,000 for the work. Okay. What they are doing is they are not doing any work. Okay. As of now, they are not doing any work. Okay. What they are doing is they do a contract with the client. Agency A does a contract with a client of designing a website for a price point of, let's say, $2,000. Then that agency A reaches to you. okay, which is agency B, and says, hey, I got a client who's paying me $2,000 for getting the WordPress or website stuff done. Now, what is the price that you would charge? You say that, okay, I'll charge for this project $1,000. So now that company is giving you the whole project, and that company is taking that $1,000 as a commission, as a fee to manage all the things. The name is of agency A, and the work is done by agency B, and agency B is your agency. That is called a white labeling agency, where you partner up with some other agency rather than searching for clients. So the work of agency A is to search for client, and your work as an agency B is to fulfill that work. Okay, so we call it fulfillment agency, we call it white label agency. There are a lot of names to it. So that's what you can do. Next is power partner. You know that a friend of yours, for me, one of my friend is in Australia, is very good into real estate. And there's one other friend of mine who is one of said to be the top people in the software industry. Okay. So what I do is I would partner up with my friend in Australia and with my friend in US who is in software industry. And I tell him, hey, dude, get me, introduce me to all your friends and all your all the people who are actively pursuing software industry, because again, if he's in software industry, he would have a lot of connection in that industry. So introduce me to those people. Every person that I close because of your introduction or because of you introducing me, I would give you a commission, which means you are using the contact, you are using the network of a person who's already established in the niche, to whom people easily trust. Okay, and the example that I'm giving you is a real example that I'm actually using in my business. Okay, so we call it them power partners, and power partners are simple. You take a leverage of anyone else's network, you give him a commission on sales. Sometimes they do the closing and sometimes you need to do the closing. So it depends who's doing the closing. Okay, closing simply means this: converting a client into a, like converting a prospect into a client. Prospect is someone who can be your potential client. So we call them as prospects. So power partners are this. Next thing is niche specialist. Someone like, let's say, consultants. Okay, consultants are a very good example of niche specialist. What they do is they have built an audience. They have built an audience around a particular niche. Let's say some people have built their audience, their community around, let's say, communication courses. For example, we can take Rahul Bhatnagar here, or Rahul Bhaiya, as we say him. So Rahul Bhaiya has, let's say, built a community around this. For example, so anyone has built a community, then what I would do is I would give him this offer that I'll do a webinar in your community. I'll do a session in your community, or I'll give a free one-on-one call to your community, to whoever is looking to accelerate their business, to accelerate their journey with courses or with something else. Okay, so this is called partnering up with niche specialist. So rather than starting to grow in a market where you don't have any connection, you can do stuffs like this to partner up with people. So a great example, again, let's move to the next option, is contracts. Again, this video is gonna be long. Okay, I hope that this is quite long video. So the next thing is contracts. You can have a lot of different type of contracts in an agency. You can have you need to have it. It's not like you can have or you don't need to have or something like that. You need to have contracts, because contracts make both the parties liable to follow something. It's not like aaj mera mood nahi kiya to I would not do the work. When there's a contract in place, the people are abide to follow the contract. But as we are in different countries, sometimes it becomes hard for a person to follow a contract. For example, if someone even breaches a contract, which means, let's say we have a contract with someone that he needs to work with us for next 6 months, even though he breaches up those contract of that 6 month, we cannot do anything. Okay, we cannot do anything, because we are in India, and the law, that Indian Panel Code, which is IPC, the laws that we follow, or Indian Panel Code, I'm not such a legal person, cannot be implemented on that person. So contracts play an important role, but typically when you are two countries away or you both are in different countries, sometimes they become negligible. But what I have seen with time that it's important to have contracts in place. There are three types of contracts that we majorly create. Contract one is called employee contract. Contract two is called client contract. And contract three is called non-disclosure agreements, NDAs. You'll be having this NDAs, like you'll be hearing this word if you're in agency business a lot of time. So employee contracts, if you have hired a great talent, you need to have a contract with him so that he does not learn things from you. And then after learning those things, he starts his own agency or he goes into your competitive agency and starts working there. That's the reason you need to have an employee contract. An employee contract is simple. Employee contract is where you need to follow something like you'll work with this client for this much months. You'll work with this client or you'll work with me for another 3 years and I'll be increasing your payment by 10% every single month. This is how a contract is formed. Okay. If you are thinking to work in a big agency, this is how the contracts are being followed. Next is client contracts. Client contract is somewhere where you can have this specifications on board. Like we'll work for this much money for this much months. We'll make sure that we would deliver this services. We would make sure that we respect your privacy and things like that. Next is called non-disclosure agreement. And non-disclosure agreement is sometimes given by the client. So non-disclosure agreements are, if a client asks you to sign an NDA, it's not something like he's just trying to put a bullet on your shoulder and trying to fire over you. It's not like that. Non-disclosure agreement is where you cannot use a client assets once you stop working with him. Client assets include his name, his videos, his images and things like that. Okay. So this is called a non-disclosure agreement where you cannot disclose even that you are working with XYZ client. That's how NDAs work. Or there's some things like you cannot disclose the insights. You cannot tell the average cost per customer. You cannot tell that what's the internal management is thinking. You cannot tell that what are the next big move that the company is doing. That's a part of NDA. By the way, guys, the person who's telling you this much things is just 18. Okay. My age is just 18 when I'm recording this video. Next is you need to register your company legally because jab tak koi cheez paper pe nahi hai, tab tak wo dunya mein nahi, okay. So I have made this quick calendar for all of you. So just try to understand. If you are registering your company in India, so you are doing an Indian company, you get four different options. You get private limited, limited liability proprietorship, one person company and proprietorship. And I have discussed these things like how to register, what to register, everything. When you become a part of my course, Agency Growth Secrets, there's a 45-minute complete video that guides you through the whole process, which bank is good, which bank is bad, where to register. I've even given you contact of my own CA. Okay. So do like things like that. So legal, then you need to have an Indian company, and in an Indian company, you should have a private limited company. You can have an LLP company, which is called limited liability proprietorship. Then there's one person company and there's proprietorship. Inside the private limited company, you need to have two or more people. There is a lot of overhead cost there. And you need to have a look over your GST and other filings like ROC and other filing, like all the Indian process. So you can have an Indian company and you get four options of creating an Indian company, which is a private limited, a limited liability partnership, this OPC, which is one person company and proprietorship. So private limited and LLP are more or less the similar. OPC and proprietorship are more or less or similar. Okay. Again, I'm not a CA, but I have given a detailed information. If you check out devrasingh.com/AGS. Next is in the legal way, you can use US based LLC, which means you register a company in USA and from your Indian address using a service called as Stripe Atlas. Okay. You can use the service called as Stripe Atlas to register a company from India into the US market. And when you have a company in US, they have like pretty much corporate taxes and things like that. It's quite simple and easy. It's not as easy as it seems, but it has some edge over the Indian partners. Okay. Or the way Indians we do. So That's an example. You can have a US-based LLC, which is limited liability company. And you can do it by using a service called as Stripe Atlas. How to register this, again, is discussed in detail in Devras Singh when you become a part of Agency Grow Secret. And while you create a company, you also need to create a bank account. If you're creating an Indian company, you need to create an Indian bank account. If you're creating a US-based limited liability company, you need to create a US bank account. But initially, for start, it's okay to start as a proprietor, as a freelancer. And when you are growing, you can do this whole process, okay? So it's not like that all these things that we are discussing, you just have to do it on day one. It's never like that. You can slowly grow. You can slowly grow the things, and then you can do the things accordingly. It's not like on the day one, you need to put everything that I'm talking about. Everything has a process. Everything has a time. Next is hiring. Hiring would play a really important role in the growth of your company, because if you need to grow your business from $1,000 a month to $10,000 a month, and you are getting $1,000 a month working as a single person, okay, you are making $1,000 a month. That's healthy, like 70,000-80,000 rupees you are making as a individual. And now you want to make $10,000. You cannot do it alone. You need 10 person like you to make that $10,000 a month. And when you need 10 person to do like you, you need to train them. You need to educate them. You need to hire them. And that costs you money. Okay. But you can do it. Agency business can be done as a single hand business or as a business where a lot of people are involved. In hiring, you can have 4 different options. One is sales. One is prospecting. One is fulfillment, and one is training. You need people to do sales. Okay. Like the 4 key job roles in an agency, or the 4 main divisions in which we hire people, is one, to do sales, because sales is the key of an agency. Like it's the backbone. Agar client hi nahi aayega to paise kahan se aayenge? If there's no client, for people who want to understand in English, if there's no client, from where would you make the money? Okay. So sales play an important role. Next is prospecting. There's someone who needs to do. So basically, this is how the calendar works. Prospecting, sales, fulfillment, and training. This is how it should. So first, someone is doing prospecting on day in and day out basis. Now, what's prospecting? Prospecting is reaching new customer, reaching new people, growing new clients, getting new clients, and hiring them and firing them and things like that. Okay. So someone of your team who is day in and day out is searching for client. He would be searching for client. How to do prospecting in the best manner? I have included it inside Agency Grow Secret, where you learn a lot of methods to grow your agency or to grow your business. Okay, so prospecting plays a really important role. Next is sales, and then comes fulfillment, and then comes training. Sales is where you hire people who do sales on behalf of your agency. We have a sales team based out of US because our clients are in US, and we focus on these US and UK clients. So we have the teams there. Next is a fulfillment team. A fulfillment team is who do a particular work, which means like they have a job role and they complete the job role, which means some people can have a job role of doing Facebook ads. Some people can have a job role of creating content. So basically, for whatever you do the sales for, or whatever your agency specialization is, people do that work or people do the fulfillment. So that's called a fulfillment team. And next is, if you need to grow your agency, you need to hire trainers. You need to hire trainers so that they can teach new people of how to do and what has been done in your agency in the past. And that can be followed. That culture can be followed so that every person who's becoming a part, or every client who's coming in your agency, experiences the similar way of doing business. Okay. Next is scripts. So you can get clients by using cold emails, LinkedIn scripts, and Facebook messaging scripts. These are only the 3 ways, and Facebook ads is the 4th way I have not mentioned, because if you're just starting, you don't need to put your money on Facebook ads, because Facebook ads are very, very costly. Okay. So scripts, cold email script, LinkedIn script, and Facebook messaging script. These are the scripts that you need. Again, that is there inside Agency Grow Secrets. You can check out those scripts. But cold emails are simple. You send out emails to people randomly who are working in a particular niche or in a particular category. And you try to have a call with them and then convert. convert them. Similarly, you can use LinkedIn scripts where you send out messages to people on LinkedIn to get them as a client or to just schedule a call with them. Next is Facebook messaging script. You need to have set of messages. Script is simple. A proven messages that helps you to get your desired goal. A proven message like, hey, I can help you to get clients from $0 to $10,000 in 10 days with my proven marketing. This becomes a script. And script is important because script is something which is proven that it would convert, okay? So you can go ahead and use this. So overall, in order to grow an agency, you need all these things. And if something can be started with as less than as 0 rupees, you just need to spend money on learning how the business works. Isn't it a great deal? I think it's a great deal, okay? So become a part of Agency Growth Secrets. Maybe you'll find the link in the description, and link is here as well. Okay, this is the link here as well. You can become a part of Agency Growth Secrets where you'll be learning this thing. And if you don't want to put in your money, just subscribe to this channel. I'll be putting out more and more videos like this for you to grow your agency or to grow your business online. So I am someone who would be posting a lot of content on Instagram, on Facebook, on YouTube. So take those content very, you can think about those content as a free knowledge and see. You will be thinking like everyone these days is having some courses, because people are having the courses because others need it, okay? People need courses to learn because there's a lot of knowledge that's not being taught in our colleges. There's a lot of knowledge that's not being taught in training schools, okay? And if I can share you that knowledge and that knowledge can help you, why not I just share it, okay? Some people would also have, if you're making so much money out of agency, then why are you selling your courses? Everyone likes to share their knowledge. Agar wo knowledge mere paas hai, toh I can make up to some money. But what about after that? Okay. And yes, we do this as a way to increase an extra channel of money. Okay. An extra revenue source. So that's pretty much it. So thanks for having this video. I do hope that you have liked and subscribed, and do check out the Agency Growth sales page. Have a great day. Thank you.